Hello guys and welcome to my new video. If you are following my progress on Facebook and Instagram, you probably know that I'm currently working on the artwork version of Anna from Disney's Frozen. I want to cosplay the Hannah Alexander artwork version because I love all of her designs. They all have a nice ombre look and a lot of details. Today I would like to show you how I dip dyed her skirt.
I am using a yellow chiffon fabric for my costume. First of all, I like to get all the seams done. You can also do them later, but I think it's better to do them first because the fabric does not fray during the dye process and you can also dye the seams that way. Just make sure that you are using a polyester thread instead of a cotton thread. Otherwise, it's not possible to dye the seams. This is how my fabric pieces look after I finished the seams with my serger. Let's get started with the dyeing process. I'm using an old crock pot for that step, but you can also use a regular pot or a bucket. The good thing about a crock pot is that you can always reheat the mixture. Fill in 4 liters of water and wait till the water has a temperature about 60 degrees. I am using Rit Dye More. This product is used for synthetic fabrics only. They have a huge color range. The color I'm using today is called Apricot Orange. But you can also use other brands like iDye Poly for your project. I will add the whole bottle to the water and mix it with an old wooden stick. Make sure you do not stir the mixture too fast. Before you dye your costume fabric, you should do a test run with some leftovers. Here you can see 3 different test pieces. The color results depends on 2 factors, the temperature and the duration of the dyeing process. Before we start our dip dye process, you should put the fabric in a water bowl. The gradient gets a lot softer during the dyeing process if you are using a wet fabric instead of a dry one. Now put the fabric into the mixture and stop at the point where your gradient should stop. Spread the fabric all around your pot so the color can sink into it. I always like to spray some cold water on top with an old spray bottle. So the gradient gets even softer and the color does sink in really slow. You should clean the ground all around the pot and lay some paper towels around it. Make sure you move the fabric from time to time. The whole dyeing process I'm showing here took about half an hour. I just want to show you a second method which you can use if you don't have a crock pot. I already put the mixture into my cooking pot and heat it. You should put a bowl with water right next to it. You can also use this method with 2 pots and 2 different colors. They will connect at the middle and create a nice color mixture. As soon as you reach your desired color, you can wash the fabric. I like to do this by hand with cold water first. You should wash the fabric until the water becomes clear. You can wash it in your washing machine later. This is how my finished skirt looks afterwards. You can create really nice effects and different results with multiple colors. As you can see, I also added a lot of rhinestones for the perfect princess look. I hope this tutorial was helpful and you can use it for your own cosplay projects. If you are interested in more sewing or fabric tutorials, let me know what you would like to learn next. Don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss my next video. Thank you guys for watching.